Thank you very much, first of all. I am very happy to be part of this panel. I'm going to speak in French and in English alternatively, so I apologize to translators and interpreters.
To say that in the message of this morning, message of His Majesty King Mohammed VI to this conference, saying that Africa should be in the new world stage, I think is important for all the micro approach that you just said about the growth, human capital, and all the agricultural potential and different resources that Africa do have. As the three major challenges, and I would like to shorten three of them, that we face as investors. First challenge is more regulatory and doing business. You highlighted Rwanda. Rwanda is really exceptional in terms of doing business. Fast, zero corruption, 10 to zero corruption. So things that, how you say, music to ears, to investors, private investors' ears. So an easy doing business and regulatory. So the legal framework and the regulatory framework are often either non-existent or flawed with delayed investments, and sometimes even they do compromise the viability of the investors. Doing business is related often to red tape, bureaucracy, heavy bureaucracy, not clear procedures. This is a challenge for private investors, that they have to find their way, understand the potential is there, but how to access it, short and clear way. This is it, and it is also it does cost a lot to in terms of in investment when you're not in the same time zone, let's say, as the bureaucracy within the country that you want to invest at, as a private sector. So this is the paradigm that is important to highlight. Secondly, education. Education, we see it as investors, as human capital skills. We need skilled human resources so we can match our competitivity and productivity. And we can see that my friends, bankers and insurance companies that have one of the biggest network in our continent have invested a lot in terms of vocational training and building capacities. But also industry, I can see my friend from CID in engineers. They are key players in terms of asset for investors. We can also highlight the fact that Moroccan investors have been very they do some tutoring also in terms of facilitating to each other the channels. When we go to a country and we know that OCP is there, OCED is there, we created a kind of a hub where we can discuss our problems, thanks to our Minister of Foreign Affairs, which is very exceptional. You were talking about the vision of His Majesty and the will to make a good South-South integration, but we have also administration through the Ministry of Foreign Affairs are playing key role to facilitate the doing business for Moroccan companies to go and invest. Besides, of course, the banking and the insurance companies that are there, I would like to go to the next third issue is economic infrastructures. They do cost a lot in terms of investment. The energy cost is not competitive in most of the African countries. It's two or three times the price of any Southern Europe countries such as France. They don't have any fossil energy. So access to energy is expensive. Connectivity and logistic connectivity it does cost a lot in terms of GDP. 20% when elsewhere it's only between 8 and 10, up to 12%. So it does impact our competitivity. But also we don't have, another challenge is a plug and play areas. When you do invest, you want to have a platform where you can go. Either you're an industrialist or logistics or engineer. You don't find a zone in the, we can talk about specifically industrial zone where you go and you have just a plug and play, you have electricity, you have your roads, and yes, I'm almost through, I think, in a second, few seconds. So to wrap up, three challenges that I talked about, and it does impact competitivity, but still opportunities are there. So those who go there have to address those issues to make their project viable and competitive at the end.
Vous avez encore une minute peut-être
encore
pour me dire
très bien.
Du coup
1 minute. So what can you tell us in spite of the difficulties that you have just identified, which is really an agenda of reforms for African governments or even for the international investors? Why do you continue to mobilize yourself in Morocco on this region if it's so difficult? I'm going to tell you. First, Africa is not a country. It's a whole continent. It's a group of countries. And we begin to see new leaders, new political leaders, they come with a new mindset. So automatically, when you see that there are opportunities, but you have new political players who come with new plans for economic and social development. They come with programs to fight corruption, heavy bureaucracy, and who have cross-section programs, such as the one that we're in Morocco for agriculture, others for industry, for energy. You begin to have visibility. In the past, we didn't. There was opacity. We could not project, have forecasts for more than 2 or 3 years. So if we're going there, it's because we're beginning to have visibility. For every enterprise, when they begin to do risk assessment and when they see visibility, they do go for things, although there are difficulties. So we can limit the risks. We can better understand the risk. But you have visibility on public policies, on strategies. And there's also an important point, that is the private sector in these countries, in some of these countries, at least in Africa, and it's more and more the case, the private sector is associated upstream in with strategic plans, sector-based strategic plans. So there is this view from this private sector, which is an added value, new partners. And for us, this is it's an added value, and this opening opportunities that we are ready to take. I think Morocco has played an important role in this South-South integration.